Okay, so today we'll try to cover thread priorities. We know we can have multiple threads in a program, and when we create a thread, then the default priority is 5. Okay, so default priority of a thread is 5. Is there, and we can set the priority. We can get the priority of a thread. What is the priority? If you want to know, you can. There is a method to retrieve the priority. There is a method to set the priority of a thread. So normally the thread priorities varies between 1 and 10. It varies between the value 1 and 10. The default priority of a thread is 5. You can also specify the number with this, say, macro norm underscore priority, min underscore priority, and max underscore priority. They represent the corresponding, say, minimum priority represents 1, max priority represents 10, and norm priority represents 5. This is the function, say set priority. This is how you can set the priority, and you provide the priority value that you want that particular thread to have. Say normally when you create a thread T, it will have a priority 5. If you want that thread to have priority say 8, you can say provide 8, set priority 8, or you can provide say norm priority plus 3, 5 plus 3, either way you can provide. Get priority. So get priority is a function which retrieves the priority of a thread, and you can display it on the screen so that you can come to know what is the priority of a thread. So this is something about thread priorities. Okay, now let's try to see the demonstration of this thread priority. Okay, so here it is a very simple program. Here we have created one class known as clicker class. So name is clicker. You can have your own name here, name of your choice. It implements runnable. Since it implements runnable, we can say clicker is a thread class. Since we are implementing it from a runnable interface, clicker is a thread class. Okay, then here we have one variable, long click is equal to 0. One long type of variable we have created, click, and it is initialized to 0. We have created one thread T. We have created one variable running. The variable name is running. It is private, volatile, boolean. We will see what do you mean by volatile. It is private, it is volatile, it is boolean. Running is equal to true. It means it can either have a value true or false. We have created this variable. Then there is one constructor, clicker class constructor. It accepts one integer value, it creates a new thread, and it sets the priority of a thread with the value you receive as an argument from here. So this is the constructor wherein you create a new thread and you set the priority of a thread. You have a run function. Run, as we have discussed yesterday, that run marks the entry point of a thread. So whenever thread gets a chance to execute, it will call this run function. And what we have written inside the run function, that while the value of this running variable is equal to true, while this variable is true, increment the value of this click plus plus. So if the running is true, you start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you keep on incrementing the value of this click variable. And when running is equal to false, you exit from that while loop. This is the logic written in the run function. There is a stop function that we have written, and inside stop function, we make this running value is equal to false. Initialized running is equal to true. Here we have written a stop function which will say change the value from true to false. so that this loop will exit. We have written one start function, and inside start function we have written t dot start. So if you don't want to write this function, you can simply write t dot start here as well. There is no issue. Here we have written a separate function start. Inside that we have written thread dot start. Basically you can write it here t dot start as we have seen yesterday. You create a thread, you start the thread. It means thread is in ready state, and whenever thread gets a chance, it will execute this run function. But in this program, we have written start as a separate function, and inside that we have written t dot start. There is no issue if you can also write it here as well. So this is our thread class. So basically the purpose of this class is let's say we have created two threads, thread 1 and thread 2. So thread 1 will get a chance to run, thread 2 will get a chance to run, okay? And for both of them, value was initialized to 0. Both of them, the value of click is initialized to 0. So given a time of say 10 seconds, what will be the value of thread T1 click? How many times this loop will run for thread 1, thread 2? If thread 1 and thread 2 are of say two different priorities, definitely the thread with a higher priority will get more resources, will be able to run this particular function more number of times as compared to the thread which is having less priority. So what we have done here is, let's say this is our main class main function. So thread dot current thread, it means the main thread dot set priority. You set the priority of a main thread to thread dot max underscore priority. Max underscore priority means 10. Main thread ka priority aapne set kar diya hai 10. After that, you have created two threads. Since clicker is a thread class, you have created an object of class clicker. It means you are trying to create two threads. The names of those threads are high thread and low thread. High and low, the two objects representing two threads you are creating, and high thread has the priority thread dot norm priority plus 2, so 5 plus 2 7, and low thread has the priority norm priority minus 2, it means 3, 5 minus 2, that is 3. Here you have called that start function exclusively. Low dot start and high dot start. So low dot start means start the low thread, start the high thread. If you don't want to write here, do not create this function exclusively. You can write it here. Whenever you create a high thread and low thread, automatically they will be in starting phase. But here we have written it, so we have started both the threads. After starting the high thread and low thread, we have written thread dot sleep 10,000. It means the main thread, here the main thread is running. So main thread go to sleep for 10 seconds. So main thread is now in suspended state. Main thread is now sleeping. Main thread is in suspended state for 10 seconds. Now during these 10 seconds, are there any other threads which can do some work? Yes. During these 10 seconds, we have two threads, high thread and low thread, which are started and ready to run this run function. So high thread is there and low thread is there. So for this 10 seconds, high thread and low thread, both the threads will try to gain control of this function and try to click. Okay. After that 10 seconds, we want these both the threads to stop. after that 10 seconds we want both the threads to stop. So we have called the stop function. The stop function will initialize the value of variable is equal to false, and if the variable is false, both the threads will go out of this while loop, and then we can have both the threads to stop. We have made both threads to stop. After that, just for surety, just to check whether both the threads have completed their execution, we will call join function. We have studied yesterday, what do you mean by join? Join means for a thread, high thread dot join means it will wait till high thread completes the execution. It will wait till the low thread completes the execution. Once high thread has finished and low thread has finished, you will come here and you will print the values of click variable for low priority thread, and you will print the value of click for high priority thread. It means how many number of times the low thread executed and how many number of times this high priority thread has executed. So this is the logic, because high priority thread is the priority of 7 and low priority thread is having the value 3. Let's try to run this program. So this is the program. Let me compile it and let's run this program. So it will wait for 10 seconds. For this 10 seconds, high priority and low priority threads are competing to take the resources and run that clicker function. So here you can see that the low priority thread ran for this number of times, incremented the click value from 0 to this number of times, whereas high priority thread ran for this number of times. So clearly you can understand that high priority thread's value is 3354 something, which is greater than this value. It means the higher priority thread ran more number of times. It means the higher priority thread got more chance to execute than low priority thread. So this is how you can have different priorities. So this is how you can have different priorities for different threads. And you can see how this higher priority thread executes and low priority thread executes. Then here we have used one volatile keyword. Okay. So what do you mean by volatile? Like we have studied static keyword, like static integer, static boolean. Like we have seen this different variables like private, public, protected, static, final. Likewise, we have one volatile keyword. So volatile keyword basically it tells the system that let's say you have one variable v. It is being accessed by, let's say, two threads, thread t1 and thread t2. It is being run by processor 1, it is being run by processor 2. Now, for the sake of simplicity, for the sake of performance, for the sake of improving the performance, both these processors will try to cache the variable V. Now, there are two mechanisms. Every time you try to update a variable value or database, whenever you try to hit the database, there are two scenarios are there. You create a local cache. I mean the main variable is stored in main memory, whereas you create a local cache for every operation. You update in a local cache and then final value you send it to the main memory, so that every time you do not have to interact with the main memory. So in this case you have achieved significant improvement in your performance. But when, say, suppose local cache is here for this thread, local cache is here for this thread, okay, and when one variable is being accessed by two different threads, this particular thread is not aware of this memory cache, this particular thread is not aware of this memory cache. So when we do not want such kind of scenario, we will say volatile. Volatile means do not create this kind of local cache memory for the variable. This particular variable is or can be accessed by multiple threads who do not have access to each other's cache area. So whatever T1 wants to do, do it here, so that whatever T1 has done should be visible to T2. Whatever T2 has done should do it here, so that whatever T2 has done it should be visible to T1. So in such cases, you can have your variable as volatile. This is the meaning of volatile keyword. Now, the next topic is synchronization. Synchronization, it means when you have two or more threads in your program, these threads should work together. Say when two or more threads need access to a shared resource, they need some way to ensure that resource will be used only by one thread at a time. If both the threads try to access the resource at the same time, then it will create a problem. What kind of a problem? Let's say you have a bank account in which say you have say 5,000 rupees as a balance. You have issued a check to somebody and for rupees say 1,000. So today you have issued a check, and that person might have deposited that check, and tomorrow that check is going to get clear. So at 2 p.m. suppose at tomorrow at 2 p.m. your account might get debited. And at the same time you went to ATM to withdraw rupees 4,000. You have given a check of say 2,000, you want to withdraw rupees 4,000, totally 6,000, and your account is having value say 5,000. And at the same time, at 2 p.m. 00 minute 00 second, at the same time, if both the withdrawal requests are placed for the same account, then it would be a trouble. Both might decline. Because your check system is not having idea of your ATM withdrawal. So when two or more threads needs access to a shared resource, they need some way to ensure that the resource will be used by only one thread at a time. So allow first any one thread at a time. Either you clear the check, either you clear the ATM transaction. Once that particular transaction is over, and then allow another transaction to proceed, depending upon withdrawal, either you decline or you success, whatever is the logic. But do not allow multiple threads to access the shared resource at the same time. This is the meaning of synchronization. Now, what is the meaning? How we have incorporated synchronization in this Java program? So this is the program which is not synchronized. First, let us try to understand if our program contains three different threads and the program is not synchronized, what would be the problem we will face? And then if we synchronize this particular program, what advantage we will get? So here in this program, we have created a class callme. Inside callme, we have created a call function which accepts one string argument, and it prints the string argument like this bracket, square bracket, and whatever the message we have received. Once this particular function prints the message in this way, square bracket, opening square bracket, and the message, this particular thread, the thread who is printing this message, goes to sleep for 1 second. And after 1 second, it prints this closing bracket. So before going to sleep, before this particular thread is being suspended, it prints the angle bracket, opening angle bracket, and the message. Then it goes, then this particular thread is suspended for say 1 second. During this 1 second, some other thread performs some other operation, some operation on this particular function, because this is the function to whom all the threads are calling. And once this time elapses, again the controller returns to this thread and it prints this closing bracket. So this closing bracket. So basically you have created three threads here. Hello, OB1, OB2 and OB3. You have created three threads here. In the first thread you have passed message hello, second thread you have passed this message synchronized, in the third thread you have passed the message join. So basically what kind of output you are expecting? Angle bracket, hello, angle bracket close, synchronized, angle bracket close, world, angle bracket close. You want this kind of message. Okay. Now let's try to understand this, what is happening here. So this is the function call, inside class call me. We have created a class caller. It implements runnable interface. So caller is a thread class. So caller is a thread class. When we will create our threads, we will create an object of class caller. So here caller OB1 is equal to new caller, caller OB2, caller OB3, new caller. So we have created three threads. We have one string message, we have one string variable, we have one object, one reference of type this call me created here, call me target. We have one thread variable here, we have constructor. Constructor, it accepts two argument. One is of type call me, another one is of type string. So here we have created one call me, this call me is there. So call me ka ek humne ek object bana diya, and in all the class we have passed this call me as a target object of that call me and three different messages. We have accepted target here and we have accepted a string here. We have created an, what you can say, three threads, and all the three threads we left, we have done start, t dot start. So whenever these three threads will get a chance, so these threads will call the call function, these three threads will call the call function with the message. This particular call function will be called with the message. So when first thread will get a chance, it will call this call function with the message hello. When second thread get a chance, this call function will be called with the message synchronized. And when third thread get a chance, this call function will be called for the message world. So what is happening now? Here three threads are there. Okay, now here what we have done here is ob1.join, ob2.join, ob3.join. It means wait for all three threads to finish before moving ahead. Okay, wait for all the three threads to finish before moving ahead. So here all three threads will get a chance. Suppose first thread get a chance. So first thread will print angle bracket and hello. Okay, first thread will print angle bracket and hello. After that, this thread will go to suspended state for 1 second. Now during this 1 second, second thread or third thread might get a chance. So then what they will print? Angle bracket synchronized. During this printing, this, what you can say, sleep period may get over, it may print this, or angle bracket third thread will get printed. Likewise this, hello, angle bracket synchronize, angle bracket world, angle bracket close. Some this kind of scribbled output is getting printed, whereas what we are expecting, hello, synchronized, world. Why this is happening? Because call me is a function which is shared by all these three threads. And second thread, first thread and third thread, these threads do not have any idea वेयर एज द अर्लियर थ्रेड हैज फिनिश द जॉब और नॉट, और वेदर वी आर अलाउड टू एग्जीक्यूट और वेदर वी आर अलाउड टू प्रिंट और नॉट. इट मीन्स दीज थ्री थ्रेड्स आर वर्किंग इन आइसोलेशन ऑन दिस शेयर्ड फंक्शन कॉल. दीज थ्री थ्रेड्स आर नॉट सिंक्रोनाइज, दैट्स वाई वी आर नॉट गेटिंग आउटपुट लाइक दिस, वी आर गेटिंग दिस स्क्रिबल्ड आउटपुट. Now, to make these three threads work in synchronization, Java has given you a keyword, say synchronized. Synchronized. So, what this synchronized function does is, what this keyword synchronized means? It means that the shared resource, here the shared resource is this function call. Call function is a shared resource. All three threads are calling this function. Okay. So this shared resource must be synchronized. So before this function, you need to write synchronized keyword. So synchronized void call string message, synchronized keyword. And after writing this synchronized keyword, if you run this program, you will get a proper output like hello synchronized world. So what is the meaning of this synchronized? This synchronized means you must serialize access to a call. Serialize the access. Means once the thread one starts executing this, okay, do not give the control of this synchronized resource. Do not give the control of this synchronized resource to another thread. Let thread 1 completely execute this function. Then only give this shared resource, access of this shared resource to different thread, to another thread. This is the meaning of this synchronized keyword. So synchronized is a keyword which which tells you that this particular resource is shareable, is mutually exclusive in shareable. So mutually exclusive means at a time only one thread can access it. Okay, you cannot leave execution pending for one thread and give the control of this resource to another thread. It will be like say five users are there and sharing a common printer. Let printer 1 be allocated to user 1. Let user 1's job gets completely printed, 5 pages, 10 pages. Then that particular shared resource is locked by user 2. Let user 2 complete the entire printing process. If that printer is not synchronized, if that printer is not, what you can say, use proper locking mechanism, then what will happen? Say 5 users have given print at the same time. Okay. And all of them have given 5-10 pages. So first user's first 2 pages, second user 3 pages, and fourth user 2 pages, fifth user 2 pages. This kind of random pages will get printed. We don't want that kind of pages to get printed in the output. What we want, whoever prints get allocated to the printer first, we don't mind. If 5 users give print command at the same time, we don't mind printing the fifth user's, the entire print first. But whoever the printer is selected, what we want is let the job be completed. The first users all the pages, then second users all the pages, fourth user all the pages. Okay, so when we want this kind of thing, the synchronized keyword is there. You need to write synchronized keyword and then the function. It means this function is synchronized. This is the meaning of synchronization. And the last topic is that inter-thread communication. Here what we have seen in synchronization is that the function which these threads are sharing, that particular function is synchronized. I mean access to that particular function at a time, I mean only one thread can access at a time. It will complete the function activity and then only that function is allowed to be used by any other thread. But here thread 1 and thread 2 and thread 3, they are not communicating with each other. They are not passing messages to each other. They are not, the status of one function, the status of, the thread 1 is not displaying the thread one is not giving any message that I have finished, you can start executing now. This kind of inter-thread communication is not there. So there is a way in which inter-thread communication can happen. It means there are three functions. One is wait, another one is notify, and notify all. These are the three functions using which you can achieve this inter-thread communication. So wait. Wait function, it tells that thread to give up the monitor and go to sleep until some other thread enters the same monitor and calls notify. Wait means tells the calling thread to give up the monitor. It means wait means you wait. You don't execute. Right now you wait. You go to suspended state and you remain in a suspended state. You wait till somebody tells you to come in. To generalize examples, say there is a class going on, and suppose there is a class going on and few students came late. So they asked that are they allowed to come in and sit in the class. The teacher says wait. So what do you mean by wait means? They have to wait there. They are not allowed to enter the class. They are not allowed to sit. They are not allowed to enter the class. They have to wait there. And how much time they have to wait? Till the teacher says now you can come in. So similarly, wait means suppose thread 1 dot wait. So thread 1 dot wait means you want that thread 1 to go to sleep period, to go to suspended state till somebody tells you thread 1 dot notify. I mean notify the thread 1 that thread 1 can resume the activity. Notify means you ask a particular thread to wake up that now you are waiting for certain amount of time, now you can wake up and you can start executing. Notify all means wakes up all the threads. Jitne bhi thread wait kar rahe hain un sabko message de do ki now you all can wake up and whenever you get a chance you can start executing. वेट का मतलब थोड़ी देर वेट करो, जब हम आपको नोटिफाई करेंगे तब आप आगे कंटिन्यू करना एग्जीक्यूशन. नोटिफाई अ पर्टिकुलर थ्रेड कि अब आप उठ सकते हैं, जैसी रिसोर्स मिलेगा आगे काम करिए, अदरवाइज यू कीप ऑन स्लीपिंग, कीप इन इन अ सस्पेंडेड स्टेट. नोटिफाई ऑल, यू नोटिफाई ऑल द थ्रेड्स, हुएवर इज स्लीपिंग, हुएवर इज इन वेट स्टेट, दैट अब ये वेट खत्म होने वाला है. आप सब कुछ ऐसे जैसे रिसोर्सेज मिलेंगे वैसे वैसे आप उसको एग्जीक्यूशन चालू कर सकते हो. So wait, notify and notify all are the three functions using which you can communicate among the thread. Now to understand this program, to understand this logic, we have a program. It is a producer-consumer program, producer-consumer problem. Let's say there is a queue. This is a queue. One is producer and one is consumer. So one is producer thread, another one is consumer thread. And PC is our main class. PC is our producer consumer naam ka, ye hamara ek main class hai. Main class hai. Now what is this producer consumer is doing? Producer means producer will put the value in the queue. Producer will put the value in the queue. Suppose producer has produced value 1. It will put the value 1 in the queue. Then consumer will get the value 1. Consumer will read the value 1 and it will print. Then producer will print the value 2. Consumer will get the value 2 and it will print. What output we want? Producer has given one value 1. Consumer has given value 1. Read the value 1. Then producer 2. Consumer 2. Producer 3. Consumer 3. Producer 4. Consumer 4. Likewise, these kind of output we want. Producer should produce one value, consumer thread should read that value. Producer should produce another value, consumer should read another value from the queue. But this will happen if producer, after putting value 1, should notify the the thread that I have put one value and now I am in wait state. I will not produce any other value until you say ki you have retrieved that value and you have done your operation. So C will retrieve that value, then C will say I am in wait state and I will notify the producer that you can generate another value. Then producer will generate another value. It will say to consumer thread that now I am in wait state, I will not generate new value and I am notifying you so that you read the value 2 from the queue. So this proper 11, 22, 33, 44, this kind of output you will get if producer and consumer communicate among themselves. Otherwise, if producer and consumer do not communicate, producer keeps on producing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Consumer, whenever get a chance, he will get 1, 5, 2, 3. So you will get random output. You will get a random output like this here. Put 1, got 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. 5 times got 1. Put 2, put 3, put 4, put 5, put 6, put 7, then got 7. But got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are missing. Because these put thread and producer and consumer are not communicating with each other. When this producer and consumer will communicate with each other, so put 1, got 1. So producer will put value 1 in the queue. It will go into wait state and notify the consumer that you consume the value. Okay, the consumer will consume the value. Consumer will notify the producer that I have consumed the value. Now I am going to wait state. I will not execute further till you produce another value and notify me back. So this is how this inter-thread communication works. So this is a simple program what we have done here. We have a queue here. We have a queue class here. Okay, we have one get function written here, we have one put function written here, and both are synchronized. Whichever thread accesses it completes it. Okay, and only one thread at a time can access it. So get function will return the value in the queue and put function will place the value of n in the queue, will update the value of n in the queue. Producer thread, what producer thread does is producer thread will call this put function. Producer thread will call this put function. This is the thread implements runnable. This is a consumer thread implements runnable. This will call the get function. So producer will call the put function, put the value in the queue, and consumer thread will call the get function. This is the get function to get the value from the queue. And here we have created queue object, producer, consumer, and this will keep on going until we press the control C button. But here the producer thread and consumer threads, I mean whenever they get a chance while true it will keep on putting the value, while true it will keep on getting the value. There is no inter-thread communication between these two functions, producer and consumer class. There is no communication between these two. That's why we are getting this incorrect output. Now, to correct this, the entire program is same, everything is same. Here, in the get method, they have written wait and notify. Here we have written wait and notify. And with the help of these values, value set, we have created one value set variable. Initially this variable is false. So when this particular variable is false, not of false means true. So when this variable is false, this can execute. When the variable value is true, this can execute. So when the variable is false, get function can get called. When the value is true, put function can get called. Now what will happen? So initially the value is false. Suppose consumer thread got the control. So not of false, true, it will wait because nothing is there to read. Suppose put function got a call. Put function got a call. It will say wait. First it will wait. Once the wait period is over, it will assign the variable value n. It will assign a variable value n. Assign variable value n means it will put a new value in a queue. It will put new value in a queue. After putting the new value in a queue, reset the variable flag and notify. Notify means now this particular producer thread has completed its activity, p is equal to 1. Notify means some other thread, whichever wants to access this particular queue, can access it. So this particular thread is accessing. Since the variable is equal to true, variable is equal to true, so this particular function will come in force and it will read the value. It will read the value and it will again false and notify. Notify means now I am in wait state. Notify other to wake up. So this is how your producer consumer problem will work. And this is how you can synchronize the behavior of your multiple thread while accessing a shared resource. And you will get output like this. Put one got one, put two got two.